Thanks for joining me, everybody. And I know that I connect with people all over the world. I've checked my map out. It's really, really fun. And I know the principles that I share with you are applicable in your context. And it's great to be able to do that. So today, what do I want to help you with? Every one of us have staff, and every one of us are challenged in that area. So I want to help you and I today, as we work in and work on our business, about how we do some strategic thinking as far as our staff is concerned. I want you to remember this phrase: people leave bosses, not businesses. So let me repeat that for you. People leave bosses, not businesses. And this is work that we know that when we talk to people, when we do exit interviews, when we understand when they are looking for a new job and they come, why do you want to come and work for us? Well, I'm hoping that you're going to be a better organization than where I was last time. I hope I'm going to have a better engagement with those that I work for than I had last time. And so we know, the research tells us that these are a significant problem for people. And again, because of that, people are only sometimes only ever working at 30% capacity because the bosses around them are not really helping them as people in their world. So let me illustrate it this way for you. Recently, the end of last year, I was working with one of my heads of learning in a high school, and her responsibility is science and maths. And she got the whole team together, is about 22, and she simply gave them two very simple questionnaires to do, and asked them just to tell her what they thought about the questions. And that was about curriculum and development and learning and expectations, etc. The fundamental insight that she got back was, we want help to do better as teachers, to deliver our classes so our students can do better in the way that they learn. And can you give us the skills, the resources, the tools, the encouragement, the atmosphere, the environment by which we can excel in doing that? I was incredibly motivated because for me, if I receive that, I've got the content of how I can deliver for the rest of the year, all the team meetings to help remind them, put the words back in their mouth that they have told me, this is what I'm expecting of myself as a teacher to grow and to develop. So any employer has employees with the same heart attitude, help me do better. And this is the fundamental thing that most business owners, leaders, managers, executives don't understand. Your staff want to exceed your expectations. They want to outshine what you think they can do. They have so much potential inside of them, we never really give them the opportunity to actually step out onto the stage of outstanding capabilities because we control them. We set their agendas. We give them the jobs to do. We create their profiles. We create their KPIs, all the stuff. And I think some of those are really important for us as leaders to do. But without engagement, without conversation, without having that relationship growing with our staff, we are actually shutting down their creativity. We're shutting down their engagement. And here's something really interesting about this whole dynamic. When we want to create equity, we often think we want to create shareholders, and shareholders want to buy into the business. Now, we think when we don't have that capability, when it's our business, how can we ever create equity for our staff into our business? Very simple. When they get ownership of the business, when you give them the space to actually own their own growth and development, when you give them the opportunity to speak into their own job description and their KPIs, when you put training dynamics into their world to help them exceed and send them on MBAs and on training courses, and when you do on a regular basis, and you might have a technology business and every week you're teaching, training, upskilling, and helping them share their information across parameters and cross sectors of the business, so everybody understands the business, you create a great, powerful way for equity in your organization that your people sign up to and say, I want that. I own that, that's mine. So when they get up every morning to come to work, they're not coming to work, they're coming to live, they're coming to express themselves, they're coming to be creative, they're coming to add value to your business and to the clients that they will engage with and the staff that they work with collaboratively across the organization. So remember this, we're dealing with the challenge that people leave bosses, not businesses. And so when we are dealing with staff issues in our organization, this is part of the strategic thinking that we need to engage with, whether you're the owner, the operator, the senior executive, responsible for any group of people, this conversation is for you because there is people who've left you and sometimes you've wondered, why has that ever happened to me? I'm a good bloke, I'm an outstanding person, I'm a quality leader, I'm a nice lady, all of those things that you know and speak about yourself, and you say, well, why don't they understand who I am and what I do? It's because how you operate. And here's the deal in business. We often have to lose control to actually gain control. Because what we do is when we give it away, it actually comes back to us. There's a book called Ecclesiastes in the Bible. It says a really interesting thing. When you cast bread on the water, after many days it'll come back, and it doesn't come back soggy. It comes back with purpose. It comes back with interest. It comes back with effect. And what we don't do is we don't understand those kinds of principles. We don't put them into practice in our lives, and we withhold. And there is a book of Proverbs, and it says, those who withhold tend to poverty. It's a really powerful proverb for you to remember. So if you're withholding, if you're not releasing, if you're not giving away, if you're not encouraging, if you're not developing, if you are not as a person understanding the challenge you face that people leave bosses, not businesses, that you and I, when we lead our teams, we are the problem. Not to blame them, they're not the problem. Now, they might have some problems, but we are the biggest problem in them really not rising to their full potential that we know they have, they know they have, but the blockage is us. And I want to help you think, strategic thinking, and I want you to be willing to ask yourself the question, what am I doing today? I want you to do that. What am I doing that is ineffective for my staff, for my employees, for my organization, that will cause people to leave because I'm the problem? And so you can do that in many ways by asking your team in simple surveys to very simple questions and create them, ask them to help you create them, and then share that out, get the feedback. But here's the deal. If you don't do anything with it, your trust level goes down even lower. But if you do it and you step it out through the next 3, 6, 9, 12 months, the difference it will make that you've done this, you've said we want to grow and develop, you've got some information to work with, and you're beginning to work with that and letting them know, yes, we will do this, and this easy straight away. We're gonna add this as a value add into our team meetings. We're going to do this training so you can be upskilled. We're going to send you away on that course so you can learn the skill that you need. We're going to give you some more freedom of time, so you might want to start at 10 and finish at 6, or you might want to start at 7 and finish at 3. So all of those dynamics, the kind of dynamic feedback your team want to say to you so we can do our job and excel at it and be fruitful in it, because then what, they won't leave the business, but they also won't leave the boss. So the business benefits, the boss benefits, everybody grows and everybody lifts. And I tell you what, you can't not enjoy when you have an environment like that where people are not leaving, but people are growing. Where people are not leaving, but people are developing. Where people are not leaving and people are improving. And their vitality and their encouragement is actually happening for you on a everyday basis, and the feedback that you get and the growth that you see, because you know it's in them. And this is the way, through a conversation we're going to have today, to help you do that. I want to start with a quote from Warren Buffett. And Warren Buffett says this: by hiring only the top 20% of candidates for an individual position, you can create exponential growth. Now, I was only reading a story in Warren Buffett today about everybody waits for the Warren Buffett letter that he puts out annually about his business and where he sees the economy, not only in the United States, but around the world. They hang for that letter. And some people were saying they're a bit disappointed in it for whatever reasons, because people have unrealistic expectations about what they want Warren Buffett to do to help them answer their own problems and are a little bit lazy in their own thinking. And I think sometimes Warren Buffett holds back information to challenge people to think. What I'm asking you to do today is to do some strategic thinking about how you and I deal with the staff and our engagement. So, how do you find the top 20% of people in and for your organization? This is where it's a really developed skill that you and I need to have and understand that there is some outstanding candidates out in the market force who are ready and willing to work, but you've got to find that top 20%. But here's the challenge for you and I. We need to actually create that environment, and that's why my first area of understanding that bosses are the problem in businesses, not the business itself, because people want to join your business and want to help your business grow. So what we have to understand is if we want to create an environment, which what I've talked about, to then engage the top 20%, then you've got to do something very strategic about what you do about gaining that 20%. And so I really know that there is answers for that. And one of the ways to do that is to actually understand the power of profiling your people who want to work for you. And there is some really powerful tools, and I actually use one of those myself to help my clients get the top 20% people engaged in and for their businesses. And it's really easy to do because this filters out people who don't reach our mark that we want to set, and we've got measures that we have in our profiling, and I'll talk a little bit later about that. And so when people apply, there is automatic filters set in for people who don't qualify on various dynamics, whether they are eligible and whether they can do the job, and secondly, the larger area of suitable, how much will they enjoy doing the role. And so we set it at 80, 85%, and we know people above that are candidates we want to then interview. And so it's really important for you and I to figure out when we're going to do strategic thinking, and we want to engage the best to lift our business to that level of effectiveness and profitability and productivity that you and I know that we want for our businesses. Then we need to hire really well, and we need to do that whole dynamic really, really well. And this is the dynamic that's going on in businesses all over the world, that oftentimes the struggle that we face is, I can read people. I can sit down and interview them and read them and know what's really going on. And we now know that one of the largest areas of growth of businesses doing is what is called CV check. It's a growing dynamic for businesses because people tell lies, both on paper and to your face. And so even though you might interview them, they will tell you what you want to hear. Profiling and psychometric tools will enable you powerfully to understand what you've actually got in the room. You will have a diagnostic of them. You will have research on them, and you will have questions to ask them so you can get some very specific responses to those questions and measures by which their response comes back at you, and you will be able to know so much better what that person is really telling you. And this is what we don't do. We often will, it's on our gut feel. Oh, I feel this person is going to really do me good. Let me tell you this, your feelings and your emotions can change every 5 minutes. And this today you might feel really good, tomorrow you're going to feel really ugly. You know, depends on what's happening with the weather or with what you've eaten or the argument with your family or with a colleague or somebody trying to run you over in the traffic. You know, your feelings are going to be impacted by all sorts of things. So if you don't feel good and you've actually got the best candidate in the room, if you don't have the resources to actually do that and do that really well, you are going to get yourself into serious trouble. And so I want to challenge you to think about what you do about how you will profile and get the resources in your hands so no matter what comes across your desk, you are really going to find those top 80%, sorry, the top 20% of people to you can then really direct and engage with. And these, this is the interesting thing about these people that you are going to get into your room is that they are self-starters. They are innovators. They are energetic. They have power about them. They have authority about them. And they will bring that into your room and you will actually be able to release them to add great value into what you're doing in your business. And so, you know, this is not being average. This is thinking that, as I've said in previous shows, about doing that little bit extra, not just doing good, but kind of what Jim Collins talks about, being good to great, doing that extra thinking, extra engagement, extra strategy. And when you understand that that's what these people are, and you've got a cohesive manner by which you do it, the difference that they will make for you is really quite outstanding, because it's understanding what they bring to the room for you. So they bring creativity. They bring innovation. They bring energy. They get up in the morning, not because you want them to get up, because they want to get up and they will be there, not just on time, that they will be there above and beyond the call, often with these types of people that you want in the room. And they're often the leaders that you're looking for your business. And this is what I tell my clients. I want you to find good people that you can go, these 20% people, that you can go long-term with when you are building your business. Because when you want to build your business, you need to look 10 years' time, not next year's financials. You need to have an imagination that can see, in 10 years' time, I see my business. You answer the question. What is that answer that you see? And I know that I've got a 10-year plan for my business, where I want to see myself in 10 years' time, the kind of effectiveness I want to have, the kind of relationship and the rapport and the respect, et cetera, and the reputation that I know I will have, and I want to grow that in my community and across the world. For me, across the world, and I'm beginning to do that already with both my YouTube channel and my podcasts, and people are listening to me across the world. It's the power of imagination is amazing. And when you have that kind of long-term view and you get these innovators, leaders, self-starters, energetic people into your business and you're ready to do long-term life with them and business with them, they add amazing value because they get that you know where you're going. They get you've got a long-term strategy. They get they can be a part of something that is real and dynamic. They get they're the top 20%. They understand that. They don't need to be told. They know that. And I want you to have that. And I'm going to give you some insights in just a short while about how you can engage and what you can actually do to find out who they are. For me, I can only do a little bit in this time I have with you, but I'm trying to give you key points and thoughtful insights for you to wrestle with yourself about what's going on in your world. So let me say this to you. Not only is it not about, understand this, people leave bosses, not businesses. Understand you want to get that top 20% and you need to really think through how you want to do that. And they are really quite dynamic people. They're leaders, they're innovators. They will set the pace. They will work hard for you and they will work long-term with you. And as I've said to you, it really is important to be skilled in profiling. And I want you to wrestle with this. Don't leave it to your gut. Like I've said, it's going to change each and every day. See, culture wants to tell us. That's the way I've been very successful in doing that. And what we do is we find sometimes that people that we know and they seem to have landed on their feet and they kind of get it right. For some reason, they have ability, skill to kind of discern people and find the right people. They are the exception. 90% of businesses out there, business operators, struggle every day to kind of turn up to work and make sure work is working. Make sure the staff are delivering. Make sure the suppliers are supplying. make sure the board is giving the right kind of advice, make sure that the warehouse is actually full, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Make sure the invoice is paid, make sure the staff are paid. So many areas of challenges that the business owner has, and not everybody has that skill. And so we hear these stories and we make them the norm. Let me tell you, they are not. They are exceptional people, and for some reason, they just are exceptional. And so I don't want you to argue out of the exception that the person has read their gut and got it right. Most of us, majority of us, over 90% of us, cannot do that. So we need resources to actually help us have the insights that we need to deliver the top 20% of people into our businesses to actually help the businesses do better than we've ever seen them do and engage with before. And so we need to test our employees. And I use a very powerful platform that is used around the world, and that's called Harrison Assessments. And there is people skilled in this all over the world who can actually help you. Now, I'm happy for you to contact me, and we can do that. So we can find people for you, and you can do that via my email or contact me through my YouTube Peak Consultancy. And I am john@peakconsultancy.com.au. Happy for you to do that, because that way we can help direct you and find those people for you in those organizations, because they all have got all sorts of different names. And so it's a really, really powerful instrument that I use. And whenever I've introduced people new to it and they see what it can do, they think, wow. Because it has many levels of reports in it that helps diagnose the person that is in the room that you have already to help upskill them. But it has very powerful diagnostic tools for anybody you want to bring into the room. And we give you who they are and what they're like. We give you their traits, but we'll give you interview questions related to the job-specific role that we want them to do, so you can actually ask those questions in a very, very powerful way. And that's what I find really, really helpful. And when people do that, it really does help them. And I was talking to one of my colleagues this week, and I was just saying to her, you know, I'm a Harrison Assessment facilitator. Oh, I said, I've used Harrison. It's very, very good. I find it really helpful. I said, well, that's the tool that I'm using for some of your staff, because this person is new to the senior role in the organization. And so they were very confident that they knew I was using a highly competent resource tool to help me coach her staff, to help them actually become the kind of dynamic leaders that the organization is looking for them to do and to be. And so it's really important that we need to test, not your gut. Don't trust your gut. Your gut does all sorts of weird things. And I want you to stop and don't use the excuse, well, my mate down the road got it right. You're not the mate down the road. You're an average everyday punter like myself and like many of my clients that I work with. And I want to help you get it right. And I know by using really high quality material like the Harrison Assessment resource tool, and you can look it up on the web, you don't have to just take my word for it, and you can ask people about it. There's universities that have done it, educational institutions, all sorts of business sizes. And so I don't want you to do that, because here's the deal. Bad recruitment costs you. And we know the minimum cost is 50% of the annual salary. And let me tell you this, it can escalate up to 200% of the annual salary of the person you've hired and fired and rehired. And all the dynamics that go with that are incredibly costly to a business. So say for instance, the annual salary is 100 grand. It could cost you another 50 grand in effort, time, resources, etc. for you to rehire that person. It could cost you 200 grand. You know, that's a lot of money to be spending in getting a recruitment wrong. And I want to answer that question, because I've asked that question, been asked that question many times by my clients. How do we get staffing right? How do we get recruitment right? How do we find out the kind of people we have in our room? And I looked around for a fair while, until I found the resource that I use, and I found it. It's a 48 to 52 page document that you will get with many powerful dynamic reports in that will diagnose your person that you actually have in the room. So it stops you trusting your gut. It will actually save you money. And hey, we're in business to make money, and I want you to be more profitable and have greater productivity. And so bad recruitment will actually cost you a lot of money. And it can, and remember, by trusting your gut and those kind of dynamics and my mate down the road, bad advice is going to cost you. What, when you listen to my people like myself, who are business coaches with many years of experience, and I've coached many different businesses, I bring that value into your room as you listen to me. So I'm, by listening to me, you've done something fantastic, is you're beginning to take good advice, good insight, good resources. And this is what I now offer to my clients to make life easy for them. And I can do an automated process, or I can do an individual process. And it's just absolutely fabulous, the dynamic resources when you test. And Warren Buffett talks about that as well, that the power of finding these people is you have to test, so you know what you're actually getting in the room is really, really important for you. Now, the same can happen for you and for other businesses. If you want to, now you might be a business and you don't do it, your mate down the road does do it. The difference in the quality of people he will have and the quality of people you will be chalk and cheese. And so I don't want you to have that. I want you to be an outstanding business. I want you. Let me illustrate it this way as we come to this, drawing this to a close. 3% of Harvard graduate students of a business course only wrote a plan out of 100. 10 years later, they bought those same 100, did a survey of them. The 3% that did the business plan, did the research, did the proper gig, earned combined more than the 97% that didn't do it right. That's the kind of difference when you do assessments right, when you do profiling right, when you do testing right, on hiring the right people, you will be the outstanding business and people will want to join you. Thanks for joining me today. So good to be with you. And I really do hope that I'll be able to share with you again. Thank you so much, because we're doing business better. This is John Hardy from Peak Consultancy. Climb the mountain, see the view.